Hello, my name is Emma McCauley, and I will be presenting a proposed inundation model at the Barn Island Salt Marsh located in Stonington, Connecticut, due to expected sea levels in 2100. While past studies have shown that salt marshes have largely been able to match their accretion rates with rising sea levels, the accelerated sea level rise we are experiencing today is posing a new threat to the stability of salt marshes. We studied how elevation, flora patterns, and local sea level rise and accretion rates are interacting at the Barn Island Salt Marsh, which is in the largest coastal management area in Connecticut, to assess whether or not it will be resilient as sea levels continue to rise. Figure 1 provides an overview of our sites. It includes 4 sites. Waquatapak is the most western site and the least disturbed by humans. Site 1 is an island, a broken off headland. Sites 2 and 3 are also headlands. Sites 1, 2, and 3 were all affected by mosquito ditching in the 1930s, which impacts the way they are able to trap sediments. Figure 2 shows the expected vegetation patterns if Barn Island is following normal salt marsh conditions. The least biologically competitive, but most stress-tolerant plant is Spartina alternifloria, and it should be found in the intertidal zone close to the marsh edge. A meadow of Spartina patens should be the next furthest inland plant, followed by Juncus gerardii. Both of these plants can tolerate infrequent periods of flooding. However, they will likely show stunted growth or widespread mortality if they are inundated more frequently or transplanted into lower elevations. Mixed in the Juncus gerardii zone is Distichla spicata and Salicornia europaea, both usually found in recently disturbed or super saline bare patches, as they are outcompeted in soil that is less saline. Iva frutescens is the most competitive plant, and therefore it is found in the highest elevations. The right side of figure 3 shows the vegetation patterns we observed at Barn Island. From top to bottom, you can see Site 1, Site 2, Site 3, and Waquatapak. The dominance of Distichlis at Sites 2 and 3, seen in the orange color, rather than the expected Spartina patens meadow, which is included in the purple mixed vegetation group, suggests that the soil is more saline than expected. Bare patches, seen here in the dusty rose color, were observed far from the marsh edge in Waquatapak and Site 3, which implies a disturbed marsh. Finally, there was significant landward encroachment of Spartina alternifloria, represented by the dark green color, seen in all 4 sites. This suggests that the accelerated rates of sea level rise is increasing flooding to an extent that stresses out the more competitive, higher elevation plants, and is allowing Spartina alternifloria to transplant to more desirable elevations where it can outcompete plants that cannot keep up with this new stressor. The left side of figure 3 shows the elevation profiles we have taken at each site. Site 1 has a dome shape, with lower elevations around all edges and with a higher area in the middle. This can likely be attributed to erosion due to the site's exposure to wave activity on all sides. Sites 2 and 3, on the other hand, have a downward sloping profile with a berm near the edge. This suggests that water is coming up higher, and with it bringing sediment up higher in the marsh, and vegetation here is able to trap this. Figure 4 shows the inundation model we propose for Barn Island. In his recently published paper, Carey found that on average, Barn Island has an accumulation rate of about 2.3 millimeters per year. Since 1980, however, sea level rise in the local area of New England has been rising at a rate almost double this accumulation, at about 4.7 millimeters per year. The sea level rise New England is experiencing is well above the global average, due to fluctuations of Atlantic water circulation due to the Gulf Stream in the Northwest Atlantic. Using the IPCRCP 4.5 model and applying it specifically to Connecticut, James O'Donnell predicted 0.5 meter sea level rise by 2050. Our model, which uses LIDAR data along with a predicted sea level rise of 1 meter by 2100, shows the extent of inundation in the event of this amount of sea level rise, here seen as the red zone. Currently, much of Barn Island salt marsh is below 1 meter above sea level. If sea level continues to outpace accretion rates, the marsh will continue to erode landward. This, combined with elevation and vegetation patterns at our sites, reinforce that Barn Island is no longer accreting at a rate that matches sea level rise. And if sea levels continue to rise at the expected rate, Barn Island will be largely submerged by 2100 at all but high tide. Thank you.